The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi dears, welcome back. How are you all? Fine, okay. So, most of you have completed your works on time. Okay, I'm very happy. Those who want to complete, complete it fast. Okay, I think you have understood the last class topic, is it? So, I have to share an information. Okay, so if you not interested reading book means you have another option. Okay, please, we can listen the books. Okay, you have an option of audio books. Okay, you can listen the contents through the particular apps. Okay, if you want to try means, please try. Clear? Okay, fine. So, let's start our session. Okay, so last class, what we have discussed about different scripting languages is, and another one is, the structure of an HTML document. Clear? So, let's see what are the different tags, the essential tags in HTML and its attributes. Okay, we'll start. Okay, the essential HTML tags are, first one is HTML. We have an elements in that, is it? Last class we have discussed it. That is, what are the HTML elements? Here, the first one is HTML tag, the starting tag. Here, the HTML tag which identifies a document, it is an HTML document, which identifies it is a hypertext markup language. Okay, and it's an opening tag and closing tag. Can you say that what is it? A tag which contains an opening and closing tag means it is known as container tags. Okay, and the next one is the main attribute of the particular HTML tag. Mainly, it has two attributes, direct, dir, and language. Okay, that is the direction, and another one is language. So, here direction which represents the direction of the text or content which is in a particular web page. Generally, it has two sections, left to right and right to left. I will show you in the Xamarin program how we can arrange the direction. So, generally, the normal web page which contains left to right. If a language is like that, Arabic and another content, we have a right to left content. Okay, for that only we are having the attribute direction. And it says language, if you want to specify a particular language, the default language is English. And if you want to specify a particular language means, you can add. If it is Arabic means, AR, it is a language equal to AANG, that is language equal to Arabic, AR. If you want to specify means, you can include that. Okay, and next is head tag, the another important tag in an HTML program. We can include the script and other content, that is CSS. If you have to represent any cascading style sheet or any style format of scripting functions means, you can include a head tag. And also, it is a container tag. Okay, it's an opening and closing tags. Clear? And next one is the title tag. This title tag is a container tag which represents the title in a web page. In a web browser, the top, you can see the particular title in a web page. Okay, it represents in a URL. What you have given in that particular title. It is included inside the head tag. Clear? And next one is body tag. You know that what is a body tag? The content which is including in a website, which is all the content is including inside the particular body tag. Okay, so it is also a container tag. Clear? And the sections which contain the content which is displayed inside the web browser window. That means the contents which is displaying inside the web page, it is including in the particular body tag. Okay, and next is its attributes. The main attribute is background, like this you can give body, background, and the particular picture or color you can include. Okay, here it is a tag, body is a tag, and background is the attribute, and here it is a value. Okay, first one is background, and another one is BG color. Okay, if you want to avoid this background and you have to give the color means, you can include BG color. Okay, and here you can see an example here, body BG color equal to gray, whatever the value you can give. Or else you can give an hexadecimal number. Okay, and next one is body, that is text. If you want to give a particular color to all the content in a body or in a web page means, you can give text equal to. Clear? So you can include the colors inside the web page on a single color. Clear? And the next attributes are link. If you want to connect a particular page or content inside a web page means, so you can see in Google search engine page, okay, in a search page you will get a number of links in that particular page, is it? So that is, if you see in a blue color link, so that type of link is known as link, which specifies a particular page. Okay, and another one is a link. So here it is an active link. Here active link is the particular green color links in a web page. If it is your result is published, you can see in green link. It will be displaying in a particular time. Such link is known as active link. Okay, another one is V link. That is, if you are visited and we have returned into the again the home page means, you can see the purple color link. That link is known as visitor link. Okay, three type of links you can include inside the body tag if you need. Okay, so these are the main attributes of body tag. Another one is margins, left margin and top margin of. Okay, if you want to give a space between the web page content means, you can apply the margins. So mainly for the top content you can give top margin equal to, you can give in specific number 7 or 6, so it will be arranging on the particular pixels. Clear? So here left margin means you can use the left side content, you can give a space between the contents on the left side top, and so like this you can use the content, the margin, so you can specify the margins on a web page. Okay, what an idea. Yes. And the next one is a common tags we can include in a web page or inside a body tag or with the contents. Mainly for heading we can use these number of tags. H1 is the bigger size and H6 is the smaller size. Okay, H1 to H6 you can include for headings. Clear? Or the main attribute of the particular heading is align. Aligning the content, that is left, right, center, like this, you can give the values for align attribute. Clear? And another one is paragraph tag. If you want to include a content in a paragraph format means, you can include inside the particular tag. It is also a container tag. Clear? And another one is its attribute. You can use its alignment, that is left, right, or center, or justify means it is in correct format. Clear? So these are the main attributes of a paragraph tag. Okay, and next one is break tag. You know about that, is it? Breaking a particular line and go to the next line. Clear? It is a empty tag. What is an empty tag? Yes, the tags which have only the opening tag. Clear? And another one is HR. HR tag means horizontal line. If you want to make any line means, you can include the horizontal line. We'll show you that. Okay. And the next tags are center tag. Here, center tag is used to make a content in a center alignment. If you want to make a content in a center, means you can align using that particular center tag. Okay. And the next tags are main tags which is we are including with the textual contents. If you want to make the particular text as bold, italics, underline like that, you can use these text formatting tags. These all tags is a container tags. Clear? What is a container tag? Yes, which have an opening and closing tags. Okay. So we have for B, we can use for bold. I equals italics, S equal to stripe, and like that, big, small, strong. If you want to emphasize a text means, it will. That is, emphasize means it will represent as an italics format. Okay. These tags which we are including with the textual content. Clear? We'll show you that. Okay. And next one is subscript and superscript tags. During exam, you will get as a one word or two marks question. Okay, they will give you a format like this and you have to write its HTML code. Here you can see that. Subscript means here, B square like that, you can write the subscript. Superscript means A cube, B cube like that, we can write means that is superscript. If you want to include, you have to represent like this. Clear? Okay. And another one is block quotes. Same as bold, how we are using it represent on that type. Okay. Here it is Q also, which represents quotation marks, which will represent in a quotation symbol. Okay, double quotes or single quotes. And another one is pre-formatted. If you are using this tag and if writing a particular content in a format means it will be represented on that particular format. It won't align on any tag. Okay, so for that only we are using pre-formatted tags. Clear? And another one is address. Here also if you are typing your address in a particular format, inside this tag it will be representing on that particular format. Okay, so these are the another common tags which we are including in a web page or HTML program. And next one is an interesting one, marquee tag. That is, we can display the continuous scrolling text. Okay, so if you want to apply any animation effect or any moving effect for the particular text means, you can use the marquee tag. Its main attribute is height. It will display on a particular height in a web page. Okay, and also width. Clear? And another one is direction. We can move the content in a particular direction. If you can give a value by direction equal to up, down, left or right. Up means it will be scrolling on upside. Down means it will be scrolling on the from the particular website. You can see in that. Okay, and another one is behavior. So here we can scroll or slide, it will be sliding on, or the different effects we can use in the behavior attribute. Alternate means once it will be scrolling effect and another time it will be sliding effect. Okay, so these are the different attributes of marquee tag. Okay, and here it is scroll delay. The another attribute of a marquee tag. How much time it want to scroll after pausing on particular time. Okay. And here scroll amount. How much speed it want to move in that particular web page. Okay. And the next one is loop. Loop means we know that repeating on a particular time. Is it?
Yes.
So same, that is a looping effect. And another one is BG color. If you need to apply a particular color on the particular mark, cube effect means you can leave on that text. Okay. And another one is hex space, that is horizontal space. Same as height and width, it will be representing with that particular hex space. Okay. So what are the attributes we have studied in that mark cube? Yes. Scroll delay, scroll amount. Here it is loop, BG color, height, width, direction, behavior. Is it same as? Sometimes you will get a question. What are the different attributes of a particular tag like this? You will get the questions. So go through each and every attribute. Okay. And another one is V space. Same as vertical space. Okay. And the next main tag is div tag, divisional tag. Advanced web pages mainly using this divisional tags. Okay. They are differentiating the particular HTML programs into different sections. Clear? Each, the CSS will be applying with the different blocks, like different divisions. Okay, so for that only we are using div tag. So we have to study in simple web pages. If you want an advanced version, if you have to study means, you can study with this different divisions. Okay, so the next attribute. So its main attribute is alignment. So we can set the content in horizontal alignment of right, left and justify option. You can arrange the particular content in a particular way. Okay. And the next one is ID. If you are using any CSS or functions, you can specify its name or label. Okay. For that we are assigning ID. Okay. If you are giving it as paragraph 1 or it is color, by its color name means you have to identify the particular block in it for its identification. Okay, you have to give its label. Clear? And next one is style. You can indicate how we can display it through its color. You can display it in a different color. In some web pages you have, you can see that in different section or different colors the content will be displayed. Is it? So such contenders or such type of options we can include in a division block. Okay, and the next one is the font tags. We can include the particular font types or size, or you can apply the font colors in the web page. Okay, so its main attribute is color, size and face. That means alignment or its font style. Okay, you can include the color, font color equal to blue and size equal to 13, or its style, you can apply the font styles means the particular content will be displayed in that style. Clear? And the next one is the entities. Reserved characters we can include in a HTML web page. That means you are including the smileys or emojis. Is it? So earlier we have used the particular symbols or the particular options for displaying smileys. Okay, so like that in web page also we have particular symbols and combination of characters to include a particular symbols. Okay, here you can see that NBSP with the dollar ampersand symbol. Okay, so it represents a quotation mark in HTML page. Clear? And same as ampersand quote, same as it will display the single quote. Clear? And another one is, if you want to include ampersand option means you can use this symbols. Clear? Like that you have number of entities to include in a web pages. If you want to include a copyright symbol means you have to write in the coding with the HTML codings. Okay, so it will display the copyright symbol. So nowadays we have the HTML editors, you can directly include that particular symbols. Clear? The basic options you have to include such comments. Okay, so during exam they will ask you the particular questions as one word. What are the characters or then match the followers. Clear? So these are special characters we are including in a web page. Okay? And the next one is how we can add the comments. So first of all, what is comments? We have learned in C++ program. That is the extra comments or the instructions we can include in a program. So like that, in HTML also you can include the comments. The red letter words, you can see that. With that angle bracket and with exclamatory mark, you can include the comments. So the user can easily identify what are the tags or the comments we can include inside that HTML program. Clear? So these are the comments options, and we can see here the examples how we can include it in this program. Okay, students, fine. So the next one is including the image. You already know about that, is it? We have studied in 9th and 10th standard how we can include the images in an HTML program. You have the tag img, is it? It is an empty tag. Clear? And src is the attribute of an image tag. Clear? So like this, you can include the image tag by giving its image name, or else you can give with its directory. So you can include the image by giving the image to image in an image tag, or else you can give through its path. Okay, so note it down. If you are giving the picture and the image, your HTML page and image should be in the same folder or in same place. Okay, or else you have to give the path. Okay, if you are giving a website or web page, means you can include the path. That is the proper way to create a web page. Okay, proper way to include an image in a web page. Okay, so like here you can see the another attributes of image tag, that is here height, width, border. Okay, and same as v space and h space. So you can give a 3D effect or a particular space for an image in a web page. Clear? So these are the main attributes of an image tag. Clear? So students, let's see a sample web page. Okay, how to include the coding. Clear? So here we are seeing a sample web page. Okay, we have applied the marquee effect and we have included a paragraph and a picture, is it? And we have applied some textual effects, is it? And another one is we have included a picture as a background, is it? And we have included the different type of font colors. So we'll see how we can write these codings. Okay, so I have saved the coding in a notepad. So first we have to use the main tag HTML. Here you can see that, is it? And next, its main attribute is direction. Here you can see dir. Here I have given that left to right. The content is aligned and then left to right format, you can see here. And next is the language, it is English. And another one is head tag. Within that, here we have used a sample web page as title. So where will be the title? Here you can see the title which is displayed. Okay, and we have closed head tag, and another one is the main content body tag. Here we have used the attribute background, and we have given the image. So here we can give the image name. Okay, here I am saved the web page and the image in same place. You can see here it is the web page. So that's why I can include the path as just a name. Okay, if you are using from another folder, means you should include the path. And here next, text. the textual color you can give by this particular name, and left margin it is 50 and top margin it is, we can give the value, it will be starting from that particular section. Here you can see that. Okay, and another one is heading. We can include the first one, H1, RQ, BSS, Urugudam, is it? And second one is here, SMAP is cool. And we have applied in scrolling effect. You can see that. Clear? And another one is image, the logo of the international school logo, is it? I have included in that. Same as it is saved in the same place. And I can give the height and width of the particular image. And I have aligned the image into right side. Okay. And another one is font. We can apply for that particular image or paragraphs. So here I have applied the italics style, textual tags. And another one is underline tag. Here you can see that. Underline. And another one is emphasize. For the best citizen of nation, I have included emphasize. Can you see that? And another one is I have closed the font effect for that particular paragraph. And I have included the break tag. So the next content will be displayed in another line. Clear? So these are the content, and I have included the next section as in sender format. So I have included a sender tag. Okay, and same as horizontal line also I have included here, and the another effects which is included in this page. Here you can see that underline effect. Okay, and here best citizen of nation, here I have used in an italic format. You can see the difference of these words, is it? And like that, here also italics. Can you see that the difference? Yes. So particular side. Clear? So like this you can create a simple web pages using this HTML commands. Okay? So write such HTML programs for a different options. We'll see how you can display or develop the web pages. Clear? Can you send a sample web page to me? Okay, good. So, we'll see you in the next class. So, these are the main content we are studying in this fourth chapter. Clear? What is the basic contents and what are the scripting languages, is it? So, that's all about this chapter. Okay, so go through well, and we are going to study its continuation content in fifth chapter. Okay, so study well. It is main content you have to follow in your practicals also. Okay, clear? So we'll see you in the next session.